Hey guys, today I will show you how to insert the navigation menu into your Streamlit app. In the first example, we will place the navigation menu in the sidebar, and afterwards we will place it directly on the main page. Okay, and without further ado, let us get started. For this tutorial, I have prepared a simple Streamlit app that displays a title. To create the navigation menu, we need to install an additional library. Therefore, open up your command prompt or terminal and type pip install streamlit-option-menu. I will, of course, also leave the link to the documentation for this module in the description box below. With that out of the way, I will import option menu from Streamlit option menu. For the first example, I will insert a navigation menu inside the sidebar. The module is very straightforward. Within the option menu, there are only two arguments required. The first one is the menu title, and the second one are the different options you want to display on your app. If the user selects one of the options, it will be stored in my variable called selected. To test it out, I will insert a simple if condition. In my case, I will just insert a title with the name of the selection. And with that said, let me save the script and rerun the web app. As a result, we've got now our navigation menu. I can now navigate through the different options and the title will change accordingly. If you do not want to display the menu title, you could set it to none. In that case, the navigation will look like this. Now let us take a look at the optional arguments. For each item in your options list, you could specify an icon. You can find all available icons on the Bootstrap's website. I will also include the link to the website in the description box below. All you need is the icon name. In my case, I'm going to use the house, book, and envelope icon. Additionally, you could also use an icon for the menu title. And last but not least, you can also set the default index. So when you open the web app, which option should be selected first? The index starts at 0, which is also the default value for this argument. In my case, the first item, so home, will be selected. I will also change the menu title as I have used the menu icon. If we rerun the app, we can now see the different icons. For the second example, I will place the navigation bar horizontally on the main page. So let me copy this part to my clipboard and comment out the rest. After pasting it below the previous example, I need to insert an additional argument to set the orientation to horizontal. And now if I rerun the app, we have the following navigation bar. Let me also set the menu title to none as I do not need it here. I think this looks already pretty slick. However, if you want to customize the look and feel further, you could do that with the styles argument. I grabbed the following code directly from the documentation. You could now customize the different elements of the navigation bar, like the background color, the font size, and so on. Okay guys, and that is all for this tutorial. As always, if you have any questions, please let me know in the comments. Thanks for watching and see you in the next video.